look what I found, everybody, in the works. It's a new coin drop thing. I had to buy that. It says I'm in the deal. There was like loads of good deals going on at the works. It was really good. This is not a paid for promotion or suggestion or anything. I went in there on my own and I found it on my own. All right. It was £14, which I paid for on my own. And yeah, I thought this is great. And it's got obviously a few exclamation marks. You know, include 60 player coins! And bonus points! 10 points! 20 points! 30 points! I'm in the deal! Drop your coins here! You see what I mean? If that annoyed you, that's how much it annoys me, the amount of stupid exclamation marks at the bottom of things. Anyway, it says, play with real coins. And what I liked about it is that on the back, it says it doesn't work with 50p's, 2p's and £2 coins. Which makes me think, oh, does that mean that it works with 20p's? Because 20p's have angles on. And I'm thinking that would make a more interesting game. Let's get it open, shall we? It's an unboxing video after all. Can you imagine if that got copyright claimed? That'd be really annoying, wouldn't it? You know, by some really random YouTuber or something. Oh my god! Right, I think a sharp implement is needed here to get into said goods. It says it needs 3 AA batteries, which I've got. I mean, that's a good start, isn't it? And what else it say? Make sure the batteries are removed from tow before recharging. So you can use rechargeables in that, which is good because a lot of things, so you can't reuse rechargeable batteries, don't it? You flashing lights warning. You know, if you've got epilepsy or photosensitivity, make sure you don't buy this game because I don't know, you might die or something. And as Ashen says, look, it's the unhappy onion. No under 3 is allowed. Yeah, but I bet he is. But I don't endorse it. I do not endorse it. Did anybody really watch the comeback of Lisa Kudrow from Friends? It's a really good comedy. It's a shame it didn't get picked up for more episodes. It did run into a second series, but not very long. Anyway, we're almost 3 minutes into it, and I'm still not into it yet. I wonder how big it actually is, because it looks bigger on the box. I bet in real life it's much smaller. Oh, it's got a little case on the front as well. That's cute. So you can cheat if you like. Just move them along yourself. Oh, that's really good. That's the bottom bit. I think there's a top bit that you slide on. This must be the coins that it comes with. Maybe you should lower the camera down now so you can see it. But there we go. But I'll probably have to prop it back up again in a minute. Is there a top piece? I'm sure there's a top piece because it catches that bit, can it? Yes. And the top piece goes on like, oh, like that. This is really good. This is better than the tipping point one that I bought. It's even better than the second one that I bought. This one's actually much better. Oh, I like this. It's cute. Does it just rests on like that? Fair enough. Yes, that's okay. And it's got little spinny things and everything. Let's just pull this camera back a bit. There we go. Get it all on screen. Good, good, good. Does it vary from the box? Because there's usually always something in there. See, we've got the stickers already put on. Not very well, not very well. It looks as if they could peel off at any moment. But are all the colours matching so far? Yes. That's unusual. There's usually always something different. And there isn't. I wonder where the flashing lights are. Well, I'd know, wouldn't I, if I put it together. Let's have a look at the coins. Recycling has been stamped twice on there. We'll see what these coins are like. I bet the coins are naff. What are the coins like? Oh, the coins are quite big, actually, but they're about the size of about a 10, just shorter than a 10p, I think. I will get some real coins to put into this, obviously, because that's what everyone wants to know. And that's that. What I really liked is on this one, you can actually put little toys in. Oh, there's some extra stickers in there. Oh, these stickers to put on the coins. Oh! Oh, I thought it was actual... I thought it was actual prizes, and it's not. It's just little stickers on the coins. Oh, that's very irritating. They could have put a couple of... Oh, no, it's just pieces of card. It's not even stickers. Is it not even stickers? It's just pieces of card. Oh, well, I suppose they had to economise in some area. Oh, well. Anyway, the coins are gold and silver, which is nice. That's better than tipping point as well, isn't it? The tipping point counters are just very boring. If I push it a bit further away, you should be able to see. Can you see the bottom? Yes. Just making sure I'm still in frame. I don't know why I'm bothering to do any of that, because I've not even put the batteries in yet, have I? Let's put the batteries in. Oh, flipping heck, screwdriver needed. It's a good job I already got it in advance this time. I'm so unprepared for my YouTube videos. Oh my word, this is too big. Is this too big? Oh no, it's a... Oh, thank goodness for that. Is it undoing it? Yes, it did. Right, three batteries to go in. Is that in? Ah, it is now. The batteries are quite tight going in. There we go. That's the batteries in. And we'll screw that back up. Like so. And there we go. Is that actually tightening up? Is it going to stay in? Yes. Now, where's the on button? Is it at the side? Is it at the back? Oh, it's at the back. Oh! Oh, my flipping heck, that is flashy. Oh, wow, that is really good. It's got a little movie thing at the side, look. Let's go in for a closer look. It's safe to say that music is the music of nightmares. Isn't it not? The music is quite scary. Oh, that music is quite a little bit creepy there. The works. Is that the best? The flashing lights, I've got to say, are a little bit too much. I don't know if this is going to come across on YouTube, obviously, but it's just... I don't know why they've gone for that. I think a little blink thing would have been nicer. Like a blink, blink. You know, to go with the music? I don't know why we need to be hypnotised. Is this some sort of thing from China where it's going to slowly hypnotise us all to buy only Chinese goods and Chinese services? Let's put the coins in and see what happens. Oh, it's stuck! Yeah, these spinny things aren't very good. And it's got stuck in the back. Maybe if I put another one in. I think the coins are too light, to be honest with you. Yeah, I think that's what the problem is. Is it struggling? Yeah, look. Got a little bit of a problem there, haven't we? It's a good job that it can open the front. Oh, no, you can't. You're stuck behind the plastic. Oh, that's no good. That's really irritating. Okay. Let's put some real coins in it, because I think that's what the problem is. I think these are actually a little too big for the machine it's intended for. I hope the 20p's work. Right, where's the 20p's? For some reason, whilst I was finding the real coins to put in, I left this turned on, and the music is already quite distracting. Just to recover the the coins, look, are actually pretty much the same size as a 10p. Oops. Look, there's a 10p. And there's the coin. Pretty much the same. But I'm thinking the weight of these will be better than these. Maybe. Oh my word, the tune is actually sticking in my head. The bit that goes... Oh well. Ooh! The 20p's are good, they just hammer themselves in. It's that bit that gets stuck in the head of the music already. Yeah, definitely get this for 20p's. I had to put loads more in now, aren't I? I'm still happy with it. It is a bit disappointing, though, that the tokens it comes with are not very good. Now, I know I'm causing loads of riders here, but I'm just wanting to make sure that it can handle the weight of coins. Where did that coin come from? I didn't put that in, did I? That's a bit weird. Yay! A 120p! I love this extra spinning around thing in the middle. I think that's a great idea. Oh my word! As if this tune's getting stuck in my head already! Yeah. The 20p's in the UK... look, just a little bit smaller than a 10p. But because of the edges, I didn't use a very good example there. This is a very dirty coin. Even though I've seen cleaner 1982 ones when they first came out. This one's filthy. Where's a cleaner one? There we are. See the angles? It just makes it a bit better. I think I should get it a little closer so you can see where I'm dropping the coins in. Oh, my word! There we are, a little bit closer. Right, I've run out of 20p's to put in. No, I've got some more 20p's. Yeah. Timing's quite difficult on this, actually, because the coins, when they go in... I can't believe that coin's just come out. I'm running out of 20p's here. In fact, I've just run out. Oh, no, I've got one more left. Oh no, I've got my two that I've won. I'll put these back in. Can't put two in the same time. Any more? Anyway, I've got a 10p. You see, it says that you can't put 2p's in, so that must be the top size. But if you look at the difference between a 10p and a 2p, this is an old 2p. Is it 1972 one? Not 1970... Oh, yeah, 1971. That's why the queen looks really different. But look at that size difference. So it's no good for 2p's, it says. But it doesn't say anything about 10p's. Ah! 10p's are a better size to put in. You can actually control it a bit better. Ah! You see, I'd recommend 10p's then. Much better with 10p's. Oh, let's see if I can find some more 10p's now. I'm sure I've got some more. Have I got more 10p's? Have I got some more 10p's? Yes, I've got loads. Oh, there we go. Let's put some more 10p's in. Oh, 10p's good because they're nice and shiny silver. Oh. I thought it got stuck then. Oops. Oh no! No, don't get stuck! Ah, what's going on? It's got stuck! I don't know if it's a break. Oh yeah, you can just open it, can't you? Oh. The battery compartment even fell off the back as well. Anyway, that's my review, I think, of this. I forgot you could just open the front if it gets stuck. What had happened is a coin had got stuck behind this, and it really didn't like it. Well, it's quite strong. That's good. And as you can see, quite well made. it says there is meant to be a game involved with this, but I don't think many people are going to pay attention to it. I think lots of kids, including myself, are just going to be happy just shoving in coins into it and using it as some sort of piggy bank. Let's put some more 10p's in. Tempe got stuck again, look. Yeah, the coins do get stuck. Maybe not 10p's then, maybe. Because I've totally clogged up the middle now. Yeah, that's not good, is it? I'd maybe stick to 20p's, 1p's, 5p's, that's pretty much it really, because it won't take anything else. 10p's, it doesn't say that you shouldn't put 10p's in, but yeah, and even the size of the tokens themselves were clogging up. Oh well. Ooh. Yeah, you can't even give it out that way. And there's a piece of plastic there that you can't really see, but it is there. So you can't even plonk it down. So anyway, you can get it out if you give it a slap. If in doubt, give it a clout. Anyway, I still would recommend this. It is quite good, but don't put 10p's in it either. Stick to 1s. 5s and 20p's. Yeah, 20p's. Good. Anyway, that's it. Thanks for watching, Scrubs. Bye.